So thank you very much for coming back to my lecture on December 23rd. So my plan today is first to explain the relationship between the algebra and the algebra, and then define W-algebras. So the algebra was defined last time, and I forgot to say why it's called the algebra. And it's called Sid's algebra because this space is usually denoted by Sid's for some reason. And so by our assumption, our vertex algebra is graded. So it decomposes into direct sum of eigenspaces of energy operator H. And the eigenvalue weight is denoted by delta. And in this case, those algebra is, so Professor Kac didn't really explain what's the idea which defines those algebra, and it's actually defined as this space. It is span of some strange product is P, and which is defined by this. So this is I'm taking A and B to be continuous. And this is A I minus B. And it's a C algebra by this star product, which starts with A minus B. And so the question is both algebra has a name of two. And so what was the relation between them? To see the relationship defined the calculation of Zuse algebra as following. So I define subspace Zp of V as the image of element which has Tomoyuki weight P.
So one is called Zu algebra, the other is called Zu C2 algebra.
Zu C2 algebra, Zu C2 possible. I'm not sure what it is most used to go.
So one is Zu C2 and the other is Zu.
Zu C2, yeah.
Which is kind of one is the associated gradient of the other.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to explain. Yeah. Mm. So this is a subspace of the algebra, and by definition, this defines an increasing filtration. Of this space. And so if you look at this formula for the multiplication, so A star B it starts with A minus 1 plus, which belongs to V delta A plus delta B. Plus elements which has a lower weight. Lower means sum of with delta, the delta is smaller than delta A plus. So this means that the product of so this filtration restricts the product. Zoo's algebra. And also I have the following exercise. So what can you use that? So use skew symmetry to show the foreign identity. So this star A can be written modulo to change. This was the weight of the A, but this is not weight of the object. And so this difference between A star B and B star A becomes is that the commutator of the algebra respect the iteration in this as in the case of iteration of entropy. It's associated greatly. This is naturally a possible. And also, if you consider this iteration, the relation, this relation has a leading term A minus 2. So the leading term here and here and here are exactly the same as the algebra. So ration is given by A minus 2 and product is given by A minus 1, minus 1 product and Poisson bracket is given by A 0. So now we conclude the following statement. So we have a map from the six algebra to the associated gradient of the algebra, which so if A is an element of send it this element to A plus plus if it is element of the group we didn't have, you can say delta A. So we can send this to the element A of the something like this. So that defines we'll define a surjective homomorphism of Poisson algebras. We have a surjection from this algebra to associate predicate of this algebra with respect to Poisson algebras.
And it's not injective?
It's not injective in general. So, for example, if you consider simple affine vertex algebra level 1 associated with E8, this is not, you see, this is not injective.
Can you say it again, the example?
So remark is that sort of this. Is not isomorphism in general. So the counter example example is that the G is EA. And if you consider a level 1 represent a fine vertex algebra, a simple level 1 of fine vertex algebra. Then the R of V, so this is not the this is not iso, because this is one dimensional because it has only one representation which is itself, and this is not one. So it's generated by the weight of the element of the heat.
So you really need to go to EA?
Yeah, for EA, I think this is right. It was proved by Jenny Fink. So this is not always isomorphism, but the conjecture is that the fluid is simple and conformal. Whatever it means, then the conjecture is the variety should be the same. And if I have time, I give you some non-trivial example for non-trivial evidence for this conjecture in general. So anyway, so we have a suggestion from Lutzig's algebra and associated gradient of this algebra. So this immediately implies before. So if suppose that a boy is a list or seems to be finite, and which is by the definition that the dimension of associated variety is zero, and this is the same as the dimension of the pseudocyclic algebra is finite. And then, because there is a surjection, this immediately implies that this algebra is finite also. And because there was a one-to-one correspondence between a simple positive energy representation of fluid and a simple representation of this algebra, this implies that the number of a simple positive energy representations of fluid up to isomorphism is fine. So it has only finally many positive energy representation.
But the other way around is not clear, right?
Sorry?
The other way around.
The other way around is I'm not sure. I think it's a conjecture.
It's a conjecture.
So the conjecture, so this conjecture implies the foreign conjecture. If this algebra semi-simple, I mean, who is rational? Which means that the truth algebra. So if who is rational, then I explain this to Alberto, please. So I will not explain the pattern. Then truth algebra, it has to be semi-simple. And any semi-simple algebra is finite dimensional. So this means so the conjecture is that if V is rational, then V is easily. But this is not known. But this conjecture in fact is right. Yeah, because this is finite measure, this is really close. Oh, I mean, so zero dimensional. This is zero dimensional. I think everyone believed this, but this has been open for many. So if I said that if V is lesser than V, and if V is lesser, then the number of simple positive energy representation is finite. But a stronger, much stronger fact result it is not. The theorem it's not that simple. By RD and Don is that if V is a vice, then any V module any simple point with one. Is a positive energy. So this implies the number of simple V modules is finite because any simple module has to be. So this condition is very simple.
So, for example, if you consider just only a representation of affine conjugate, but there's many non-high-speed representation. But the statement, a theorem says if V is this state, then the simple V module is mathematical, or as a positive energy.
The proof of this statement is not more difficult, but I skip it. Because I need to prepare many qualifications. But
I don't understand the simplification.
Because any simple blue module is positive energy representation. And this set is the same as this set.
Right.
And I agree with the reset because this is finite, this is positive. And through this statement or I don't use this statement let's take this to give you some idea. So if the blue is a listed, proceeds to finite, then the Abelian category. Then it's category of representation is equivalent to some there is some finite dimensional algebra whose representation category is equivalent to the category of but this is only talking about the structure as Abelian. The vertex algebra has richer category. So as long as the module category is concerned, it's the same as the category of our representation.
But this algebra is not the Zoo algebra?
It's not the Zoo algebra, it's called higher Zoo algebra. I'm not explaining. But you cannot describe biases. There's no
theory. Zoo algebra only describes the simple modules, right?
Yeah. But if you consider
the higher, you take all modules.
Yeah.
So this means that so this is a polynomial. This means it can be any generator. So in this case, the size of the algebra is the same. The proof is so if we admit that it's in the W basis, then it's associated gradient as no zero difference. Because it's a polynomial. So this means that, so in particular, this means that the minus two product is non-zero for any non-zero value. For non-zero elements. So this means that in the associated gradient, this relation always starts to be minus. So this means that the associated gradient of the algebra is just a free over span of A minus 2. And this is exactly the same as you see. So our basic example is affine, universal affine vertex algebra. And so the associated gradient of this was a function on the space of this. So this admits a TBW basis. So by the previous theorem, we have the isomorphism from Zeus's algebra of the group KT, which it converse isomorphic to function of this star to the associated relation.
Admits a period of the is it the same as saying that it is strongly field generated by
and also it's, you find that exactly the PDW is a basis. So if you fix some order,
right.
It is the basis.
It's equivalent.
Yeah, it's equivalent. So on the other hand, we have algebra homomorphism from UG to the algebra of UKG, which sends element of Z to X minus 1. It's easy to, I explain. If you use the exercise I stated in the beginning of the lecture, you find that this map defines algebra. And since respects the filtration on both sides. So this has a standard filtration of PW, which Fetch I explained. And this has a filtration I explained. And so this map is compatible with filtration. And the induced map between associated gradient gives the same as this map. So it has to be a nice. So we conclude that the Zuse algebra of universal affine vertex algebra is homomorphic to UG for him. Then you can consider the affinization of the factor inside. associated with this space is this natural cavity. So if you write, if I write it explicitly, it's generated by this is the same fluid.
So I don't understand. So you started with letter xi and then you switched to psi.
Yeah, you just, you know what, I can use the same notation. Just change it.
Yeah.
If you
want no,
to
okay.
use the same notation, I can use it. It's quite confusing.
So you're describing what is a clip for that?
Yeah. And the corresponding vertex algebra, which Professor Kac-Wakimoto already defined, is defined. So here will be the corresponding vertex algebra. So this will be the quotient.
The commutator is commutator or anti-commutator?
So because this is an odd,
is an odd.
This is an odd. And you find that this is as a vector space. And so later I use the grading of
defined by the same way as polynomial X of finite integers. So this is defined by certain. So this is defined by setting degree of C I square n is 1 and degree of C equals to 1.
I think when you do the psi star or the psi, you have to put minus n minus 1, or not?
Sorry?
When you define this as, when you take the span,
yeah.
Where do the n's lie? M1 and 2 and r.
So this Again, any element.
No, M's.
M is, Y here is equal with 0. And in Y here is a
straight figure.
Yeah.
Ah, very good. Okay, great.
It's an algebra of this vertex algebra. So the vector space is the same as F of isomorphic to the classical quick-fold algebra I used before. The correspondence is in the exact C I minus 1, 0, and the exact star was So the associated variety of the Minicourse space is can be considered as a cotangent bundle to the coordinate ring. So this can be considered as a coordinate ring program. Tangent bundle to the purely super, purely odd superspace in the star. And so it's associated gradient. One can show that it's associated gradient as more to the coordinate ring of the hard space of this purely odd affine space. So this is a grass mark.
the ancestors, the first data says is extinct. Theorem. What's the number of the theorem?
Which thing?
Which?
All of them.
Maybe, I think it's Q9. Which so it could be W, if you agree, I think it could be W basis, then the map and the six algebra is as a model.
Yes.
Extend theorem to
the superparties. And so you have the following diagram. So you have the chiral difference of it. And if you take Zuse's algebra, you get the user sheaf of the difference of it. And the associated gradient of the differential operators is a push for the structure sheaf of the tangent 1.8. And the associated gradient of the differential operators is the push for of the structure sheaf of the space.
Yeah.
So if you start with an affine, universal affine vertex algebra, and if you take a Zuz algebra, you obtain usual entropy. And if you take a Zuz-C2 algebra, you get plus Poisson algebra of this Poisson ring of this stuff. And if you take a associated gradient, you get a function on the art space of this stuff. And we have this kind of diagram. And if you start with a fermion, a free fermion, you obtain the similar diagram. So as a Zuz algebra, you get a free-fold algebra. And as a Zuz-C2 algebra, you get a classical Zuz-C2 algebra. So, I now want to do chiralization what I did in the first lecture. So we are dealing with this lowest part in the on the first day, but I want to upgrade everything to the upstairs. So let's see KG. Is a tensor product of the G tensor F. So G is a GFN in the as in the part of the and then so this has a decomposition. To graded pieces, maybe it's not a good notation. Then it's associated graded, I mean, it's algebra. So this is just a tensor product of vertex algebra. And so the operation of these two points. So this is a natural vertex algebra. And so the Zuz-C2 algebra of it is just a tensor product, these two. And this is the CG tensor, rest of the four algebra, which is denoted by C G in the first lecture. And so the algebra of this vertex algebra is just a tensor product. Algebra. And this is the support of UG with the three-fold algebra, and this is C. So maybe I'll write you. So we have a vertex algebra CK, which gives by taking this algebra CG, and by taking this C algebra C. So if you take associated gradient, this is a tensor product of C. Maybe I make it confusing notation, but can I write like this? Maybe I assume that. So this is a tensor product function on we start with a function from J of T of N star. So I want to generate the construction to the vertex algebra. So for this, I need the output rate rho, so we have the algebra homomorphism from M to where before the algebra. So this is this is distinct to the vertex algebra from Vn, which is universal affine vertex algebra associated with this time. And because this is an invariant variant of one is trivial, so I don't follow it here. And we have a vertex algebra from here to the Euclidean, which sends x g to
sorry, can you remind us what was rho? Rho is just the natural embedding.
It's a natural embedding, so you forget z if you define.
You're just not adding it into its scope inside Kyoto, right?
No, this is induced by a joint function. So this is given by Cij. And so if you took G, and you get this vertex order. So we have so this extends the vertex algebra on function of Vn to Kg, which sends xg, xi, g to xg plus chi xi, tensor 1 plus 1 tensor rho hat xi. Again, this becomes a vertex. And by definition, the inducement between Zu's algebra is exactly rho here, and the inducement between Zu's algebra is theta ideal. And the proposition
again, M and L is the same vector.
So the proportion is exactly the same as the Hamiltonian setting. So there exists an equivalent Q hat in C K 1 D such that Q hat D 1 tensor to C by W is R. So how do you write this in terms of a lambda bracket? This is a usual OP notation. So Q hat lambda one base of C right is what
we just
did have X right?
Yes, I think so.
Exercise, as we expect, decided is the show proposition, and also Q hat G has the following.
So it's identical to the classical construction, except that we have G everywhere. So if you expand, so we expand this field as usual, then so this the lambda, the fact that the lambda bracket is zero implies so because our order field implies that the cube has zero, square of cube has zero equals zero. So so this becomes is a cochain complex. So this is a vertex algebra version of a differential grid algebra. And in particular, its topology defined by the kernel and the image.
Sorry, what is uk in your expression?
Where?
Xiz plus chi xi.
Chi xi.
Yeah, what is chi?
Chi is a. Chi is an element of theory which appearing with y was with f, and f is an important
thing. So we just choose f to be a important lattice.
Principal important.
This one appeared in your case, but in, this can be. This construction can be generalized for
okay.
In the genus, as long as it admits a uniform. As long as you need the idea of Kac-Wakimoto. But I don't have time to explain for generalization. Anyway, so the statement says that this inherits vertex algebra structure. So the proof is so we have the commutator formula which says a bracket of A n with B n is m I A I B m plus m minus I. So because if you have zero is a zero mode of a field, now we only have I equal to zero here. So this is the same as Q but zero here. And V is a cosine cube, then An, V is a Q prime, 0 A prime of M of V, which is again a cobound value. So in this way you can see that the lambda bracket is will be fine.
Can you explain why the last
yeah. Because this is a zero.
Ah,
for
sure.
N equals zero, we have only one term.
Sure.
So I didn't explain. I don't explain all, but in this way you can stretch it. The lambda bracket is really fine. So, so the topology of CKD in respect to Q0 is about gradient vertex super algebra, and H0 is a vertex algebra, vertex sub algebra. This is vertex sub algebra, which is not one soup. And so this is the double algebra. So this is the definition of the, double algebra. Now I have taken G to be G again, and it is pressed on it. So and as long as an important element is principal, this construction works for me. And in fact, as long as F admits even good grading, this construction. So I should remark that the commutator formula I explained above implies that the Q hat 0 of preserves the ideal, defining ideal of Zuzi algebra. So this is not just a defining ideal of Zuzi algebra. So this induces a co-chain complex structure on Zuzi algebra, co-chain complex, and which is identical to the complex monster in the first lecture. So if you write, so we just put G on the into definition. So if you look at the action on the user algebra, you find that this complex over differential algebra is exactly the same as the differential algebra we considered in the first lecture. So this means the cohomology of the cohomology of the induced of the algebra is delta zero and it's the same. So by taking two halves, I only cover the construction in the first.
also because it's defined by the zero mode.
Well, Z of G you just get for principle.
Yes, it's for principle. In general, this is a finite. Because it's defined as a zero mode, it preserves the fifth position. So, if you have zero, it is a chain complex. And RCKG, and if at zero, is a subcomplex, which has this as a subcomplex. So, as in the case of the lemma, what you find the its cohomology inherits. Poisson vertex algebras. Exactly the same way. And the seven. The cohomology of the associated grade is easy to compute. And we have the Banishan cohomology, and it is zero of this cohomology is isomorphic to the function on the slice. R space of slice as a Poisson vertex. So if you take a BRST reduction, you get here the center. Here the function, invariant function on G. And the theorem says if you take BRST reduction here, which is isomorphic to the function on the slices, you get a coordinate ring of the arc space of all slices. This is what we see. So the proof is the one. Proof is almost identical to the one. So we had a moment from this to this. And because the factor of taking out space this is a factorial, you get the corresponding morphism from this to JD to G star 2J of N star. And so here we have the element pi, and we have the corresponding element pi.
So where phi hat is defined by point. So it's a point of J of n star, which is identified as a point. Ring homomorphism is from C of Jn star to C, and which by definition of the half space isomorphic to ring homomorphism from C n star to Cp, and the algebra map from which sends x to pi x for element of n. We have a corresponding element here, and so I have corresponding. So this map sends x minus n to delta n 1 pi x. So I identify this. So by hat it is a ring homomorphism defined by this one. And so it's all easy to see that the pre-image of by hat is an arc space of pre-image of by hat. And which is isomorphic to the product of arc space of S, is n with the arc space of S by the fact that the element of type is isomorphic to the type S. So we are really similar in the similar situation as in the case of Costa, in the sense that we have this isomorphism. So we can do the same for the to compute the homology, and namely, so we can decompose it into two bar complex, where she bar ij is defined by. Exactly the same as before. We just have a T inverse, T inverse, T inverse here, exactly in the same way as before, we can define by degree complex. And if you look at the differential, it is decomposed into two parts. Now one part sends C hat ij to C hat I j plus 1, and the other one then C hat I j to C hat I plus 1 j. So we have we can consider this cohomology as a total complex of the complex over W.
So you have a converging spectral sequence to converge into to this complex. So event is a homology with respect to d hat minus, and its term is a homology of event with respect to d hat plus. So we compute, as in the case of find the major setting, and so the formula for, I don't write the formula for d hat minus and d hat minus, but it is indeed identical to the finite dimensional case, except that we have z here. So we find that the cohomology complex with respect to differential d hat minus is again the Kac-Wakimoto complex for the sequence xi minus n minus chi of pi hat of xi minus for I. Tensor with lambda so it follows that its cohomology vanishes for non-zero I, and for zero we give the function on the jets of the image. Tensor with grass margin. So it's just that you replace everything by that. This is isomorphic to function on. We have this decomposition, so NT acts freely, co-freely here, and so this is isomorphic to delta I zero and C for J of this. So it collapses into equal infinity, and we get the desired isomorphism.
So if you consider the associated grade the reduction of the associated grade for some vertex algebra, you obtain exactly the coordinate ring of the arc space of the slice. Yes. This was the second companion. Now, so what this implies to non-associated predicate is, so the statement is that the cohomology vanishing holds also for before taking associated predicate. And the associated gradient of the W-algebra, which is the same by definition, the associated gradient of AT0 of C, JQ0, is isomorphic to AT0 of group of CQ0, and which is isomorphic to function set of the set of compact matrices.
The previous
and in particular the C2 algebra of the W algebra is the isomorphic to the function on S and which is isomorphic in this case the invariant ring of the so you have the so BRST reduction gives define the double algebra and so if you take so if you take the 2 to 6 algebra you cover the this and you take the associated grid you cover this and you have this method. So one can to prove theorem, one can consider a spectral sequence associated with the filtration. And so if this spectral sequence converges, we get theorem 12 immediately from theorem 11. Because we are dealing with a non-Euclidean ring.
You're dealing with what?
So if you consider the spectral sequence corresponding to this filtration.
Because it's a Z, it's a positive name, right? P is a.
P is a. So usually, the convergence is. So what you have to show that the. The induced filtration of this, which is defined by image of H of FT CKT,
with h of ckg have to be zero for subset of ckg. So this ensures the convergence. But since this filtration is infinite for our case, this is not clear at all. For the associated gradient, it was okay because it decomposed into a direct sum of filtration subcomplexes which on which this so the previous recipients also has no problem. If you look at closely to this filtration, you find immediately that a problem with the convergence. So the convergence is not trivial. So you cannot conclude immediately, and I have to postpone the proof till new year. So I cannot prove it now. I need some more time to explain. So for now, let's admit this theorem, and then prove the following answers. Zuo's algebra of double algebra is isomorphic to the H0 of induced cohomology of the Zuo's algebra. And which is isomorphic to the center of the algebra in this case. So in general, this is a finite algebra. And the proof goes as following. So we have a natural algebra homomorphism which sends a Zuo's algebra of WGF to H0 of Zuo's algebra, which makes following diagram from you. So how about from Zuo's algebra of double algebra to H0 of Zuo's algebra? And you find that this respect to the filtration. So this induces a map between associated and E. And you have a surjective homomorphism from here to the Zuo's C2 algebra. And we have here, similarly, the natural map from H0 of Zuo's C2 algebra. And this was identical to the homology we computed in the first lecture. So which is a function on the surface, I mean, as slice. And as I proved, I mean, so if you admit the theorem 13, this is also a function on the surface. So this is isomorphism. And this is isomorphism also by the because this is associated gradient
predict of the center. So if from the first lecture, you know that this is like this. Because this is a commutative diagram. And we also know this is isomorphic too, because this is isomorphic derivatives. But so this implies that all these two have to be isomorphic. So this implies that. So because associated gradient, induced morphism is an associated gradient. Is isomorphism, if you get it. So that is so the story. Okay, so I think it's a good time to do this. Any questions? So in January I start with a proof of theorem 2, and then and also explain the Miura gives explicit. Realization
of what in this case. For any level?
Hmm?
For a different level.
For any level.
Mura, no.
For any level.
But for what type of F?
For this case, G equals G ln and YSLN, principal
important. But in general, it's not.
No, it's all important. Dimensional.
Any questions?
Could you maybe just to explain a little bit about dualities between W algebra?
After I explain your map, I can explain.
Okay.
All right, so let's thank Tomoyuki again.